In general, service firms compete in a difficult economic environment that presents challenges such as relatively low and overall entry barriers, minimal opportunities for economies of scale, product substitutions for service, high customer loyalty, erratic sales fluctuations, and exit barriers. Let's consider these challenges one by one. The entry barriers in the service sector are lower compared to those for the product. Service innovations are not patentable and in most of the cases are not capital intensive. Innovations can easily be copied by the competitors. On the other hand, in case of a capital intensive service, such as a resort hotel on the best beach of an island, there exist entry barriers. As customers participate in the service process, they must travel to the service facility or the service must travel to the customer. And the necessity of physical travel limits the market area and results in a small-scale service shop. Franchise companies and internet firms like Amazon, Alibaba, Trendyol can realize some economies of scale by sharing advertising and purchasing costs. Another challenge that is faced by service companies is product substitution. Product innovations can be substituted for services. For example, a blood sugar device substitutes specimen analysis services that are provided by a health service. Service companies must also consider potential product innovators. Therefore, service companies must not only watch other service competitors, but also anticipate potential product innovators that might make their services obsolete. Another challenge is customer loyalty. Established service companies that use custom services may easily create loyal customer base that becomes a strong market barrier for companies that are in the same market. For example, it is really hard to replace a hospital supply company that places handheld terminals at a hospital. In addition, there may be exit barriers in a service market. Marginal service companies, such as antique stores, may continue to operate despite their low or even non-existent profits. In such a market, profit-motivated competitors would find it very difficult to drive these privately held firms from the market. As we have mentioned before, service demand varies over time, and this also introduces a new challenge in the environment. All these challenges should be overcome by a service company through a strong competitive service strategy. There are three general strategies that have been successful in providing a competitive challenge: overall cost leadership, differentiation, and focus. And there are three general strategies that have been successful in providing a competitive challenge: overall cost leadership, differentiation, and focus. Let's talk about these strategies one by one. Overall cost leadership requires high capital investment, efficient scale facilities, aggressive pricing, therefore tight cost and overhead control, generally innovative solution, and startup losses to build market share. Overall cost leaders seek out low-cost customers. Low-cost customers are the customers that cost less to serve than others. For example, United Service Automobile Association, USAA in short, is an insurance company that insures only military customers. Military customers travel a lot, therefore do their business on phone, resulting in no need for sales force. Similarly, BIM customers do not look for a market layout with dedicated regions for each product category. I should also note that a cost leadership strategy sometimes can revolutionize an industry. For example, Pegasus has changed the aviation sector in Turkey, as we talked before. IKEA has changed the furniture sector in the world. Let's talk about some approaches used by cost leaders. First, some of them standardize a custom service. For example, income tax preparation is a custom service, but a company called HR Block works with customers that require a standard tax preparation. Another example is family healthcare centers, AFM'ler. The aim of placing such a service between patients and hospitals is reducing the demand level of the hospitals, therefore healthcare costs. Another approach used by cost leaders is reducing the personnel in service delivery. This strategy includes a risk of losing the customer. However, if it is more convenient for the customers, then the customers accept this new model. As an example, we can give ATMs. People prefer using ATMs instead of going to bank for standard banking services. Some services, such as utilities, require high fixed costs associated with network construction. Some cost leaders that provide such services reduce network costs. For example, FedEx uses hub and spoke network for overnight air package delivery. Let me explain a hub and spoke network by using that of FedEx. FedEx has a hub in Memphis, and any package is first transferred to this hub and then to its destination. Therefore, there is no direct transfer between any pair of nodes in the network other than the hub in Memphis. By this way, all packages can be transferred to the destination in one day. Many services, such as hair cutting or education, should be online. Some of the cost leaders take service operations offline. For example, Coursera has significant cost savings through taking the students physically out of the education process. And differentiation is another strategy that is used by service companies to overcome the challenges in the market. We see differentiation in many forms. It can be in brand image, for example, Apple's image. It can be in technology use. Again, we can give Apple and its operating system as an example. Or it can be in customer service feature. For example, American Express offers complete travel services. These companies ignore costs by trying to create customer loyalty. Some of the approaches used by these companies are as follows. They make intangible tangible. For example, hotels provide toiletry items with their name affixed so that the customers that take these items home can see them every time at their home and remember their memories at that hotel. They customize a standard product or service. For example, a gym might have a personal trainer. They reduce perceived risks by explaining their service in details to their customers. I know that you read the Village Volvo case and saw how Village Volvo explains their work to the customers so that they reduce the perceived risk by explaining their service in detail. Personal training is important for some of these companies. For example, McDonald's has a hamburger university where the store managers are trained. And also, these companies control the quality of service through personal training, direct supervision, explicit procedures, and or peer pressure. The third strategy is focus strategy. This strategy relies on the idea of serving a target market very well by addressing customer specific needs. The focus strategy is the application of differentiation and or overall cost leadership to a particular market segment rather than the entire market. The target market segment might be selected based on the buyer group, such as the targeted military officers by USAA insurance company, or by the service offered, such as some hotels that target budget travelers, or the geographic region such as Southwest Airlines that target Texas residents when it was established. Next, let me continue with the strategic analysis. It begins when there's a question like, should we enter a market with a new service offering? It is also used when the competitive position of a company in the market should be analyzed. There are two popular used for this purpose. One of them is Michael Porter's Five Forces analysis that is used to determine the attractiveness of a market, and the other one is SWOT analysis that is used to assess a company. Let me start with Porter's Five Forces model. It's used at the industry level to determine the attractiveness of a market. The five forces affect the ability of a firm to attract customers and make profit. Let us consider Netflix as an example firm entering video rental industry. We want to analyze the center block competitive rivalry within industry upon which the external forces act, as you see here. This factor is the major determinant of the industry competitiveness. Rivals might be aggressive price competitors, or they might use non-price strategies such as innovation, technology use, or etc. When Netflix entered the market by offering DVDs exclusively by mail, its only rivals were rental stores. Potential for new entrants. Is high for profitable markets that yield high returns. At one time, Walmart challenged Netflix, but it couldn't overcome Netflix's established brand. Threat for substitutes is another important factor for services. Both products and other services might be substitutes. For example, Netflix faces competition from cable companies that allow customers to download videos directly to their TVs. Bargaining power of suppliers is strong when there is product uniqueness or monopoly source. The most important supplier of Netflix is DVD distributors. However, through volume purchases of Netflix, Netflix can reduce their bargaining power. And finally, bargaining power of customers can exert price pressure and restrict high margins. Netflix uses information about customer preferences and recommend other movies with similar themes, therefore stimulate demand. After industry level of analysis performed through Porter's Five Forces analysis, SWOT analysis is conducted at the individual firm level. A SWOT analysis identifies a company's internal strengths and weaknesses and external opportunities and threats. The aim of SWOT analysis is to reveal competitive advantages, analyze prospects, prepare for problems, and allow for development of contingency plans. It concludes with a summary of strengths to be maintained, weaknesses to be remedied, opportunities to be prioritized and to be prioritized. And threats to be managed and minimized. This slide presents typical questions that can be asked for each category. This analysis is subjective, therefore collaboration is required when performing this analysis. Here we have a sample SWOT analysis carried for AnadoluJet. You can analyze this by yourself at home. Depending on competition and personal needs, customers select a service provider using typical criteria listed here. Availability indicates how accessible the service is. Convenience is related with the location of the service. Dependability indicates how reliable the service is. Personalization is related with custom service for each individual. Price is viewed as being a surrogate for quality for professional services, especially. Quality is related with customer's prior expectations and his or her perception during and after the fact. And reputation is really important for services, and positive word of mouth is the most effective form of advertising for services. Safety, well-being, and security are important considerations for services because in some services such as air travel or health services, customers are putting their lives in the hands of the service provider. And speed of the service is extremely important for emergency services, and response time is important for all services. There may be other dimensions for other services.